Even now, these waste products, such as nylon materials, particularly those that are called the pure water sachets, like these ones, dot the streets of Lagos and in the canals, blocking the canals in the process. And this has led to different kinds of problems, particularly flooding in the city of Lagos. But today, the story is different. Recycling plants such as this one here in Olusosun dump site in Lagos are now being used to convert these waste products into useful materials.
Any type of iron that enters that place, the machine will spoil. So to avoid it, we have to wash it here first before we take it inside the machine.
After the washing, then we try and remove the water a bit on that machine. It's also a dryer, but the way that dryer works is to just dewater it. After dewatering, then it goes into, we try to make them into flakes.
The journey of converting waste wealth in Lagos, Nigeria's commercial nerve center, began here in Odogunyo Ikorodu area of Lagos during the Bola Tinubu administration to convert waste to compost fertilizers. Categories of waste used here for composting include green waste, such as grass cuttings, hedge trimmings, weeds, plants, and in fact, all floral wastes. The compost fertilizers are not only cheaper than chemical fertilizers, but are not harmful to plants, allows them to spread out widely, preventing erosion and improving the soil texture.
It is clean, no toxic, no pathogen, only the beneficial natural microbes that are in the forest that make good.
The rate of growth is faster, one, like I show you. And again, the rate at which the seed germination is almost 100%.
We have the biggest compost production plant in Africa, where we are generating more than about 280 bags of compost on a daily basis. And a substantial quantity of our waste has been converted on a daily basis into that compost production.
The raw materials for converting waste to wealth in Lagos, an emerging mega city, is never in short supply, as the city is known for its huge volume of waste, estimated at 9,000 metric tons per day, generated by its large population of over 15 million people. The state's Waste Management Authority says the Waste to Wealth program became possible only when over 80% of collection efficiency of wastes, which hitherto formed mountains on the highways and streets of Lagos, has been achieved. With the focus now on recycling, the state government has set up recycling banks in various parts of the city. The recycling centers with compartmentalized banks encourages waste segregation, an important component that drives the process.
The red one is for can, while the yellow is for PET bottle, and the green one is for paper. Then the bottle colors are there. That is how we do it.
At the moment, the city recycles 18% of its waste and is hoping to achieve 35% by 2012.
We have a tire recycling. We've been doing collection for tires right now, and we're already installing the plant that will be turning the tires into other useful products. Recently, too, we started our waste-to-energy plants that we've started also, and very soon we're going to put on electricity from that plants, and it's coming up very soon. So the concept has actually developed a secondary line of job in waste management strategy.
In its quest for best practices, the state government is partnering with private investors in resource recovery, such as nylon plastic recycling, craft paper collection, and buyback program from scavengers to boost efficiency.
We have a buyback program where we buy back the pure water sachets from members of the public, go gather the pure water sachets from the community so that they can bring it here, their Loma officers ready to weigh and then pay them their money when they come here.
When I try this, first bring half. trailer. When I bring it after, I get 35,000. When I pay people that work with me, I still see 20,000.
This recycling plant here at Olusosu dump site is one of the results of such partnership.
We have to rely on diesel, and a lot of the profits do go on power generation. But in the long run, it definitely has great potential, definitely. Not only for us as a company or for Loma, but even for the environment as well.
We provided them with equipment, gave them specifications of how the factory should look like, the expertise, and then the skilled labor, the labor is provided by us, the machines provided by us. We manage it.
Another category of waste being recycled in Lagos is sawdust used in making briquettes, a block of flammable matter used to start and maintain a fire. Briquettes are alternatives to burning woods for heating and cooking, said to be 40% more efficient, longer burning, and hotter than wood. It therefore saves trees and prevents soil erosion and desertification. The Sawdust Waste to Wealth program has won for Nigeria the 2011 UNEP Global State Economic Empowerment and Development Strategy SEEDS Award.
Instead of the sawdust affecting the water species in the Lagos Lagoon, depleting the entire environmental landscape, the sawdust can be reused in making things that can equally generate wealth or generate income for the people.
However, one category of waste yet to be converted to wealth in Lagos is electronic waste, popularly known as e-waste. These include electrical and electronic equipment, which have become obsolete due to advancement in technology. The overall aim of the Lagos State Government with Waste to Wealth scheme is to better manage resources and reduce the impact of waste materials that end up at the landfill sites, thereby conserving land resources of the state. Nkoli Omodu, AIT News, Lagos.